Greetings everyone, it's Freaky. So I was online last night, and I came across an interesting story in the mid-1980s revolving around a series of sicknesses and fatalities coming from poisoned vending machines. I found this entertaining and wanted to make a video about it. Please let me know what you guys think of this down below. It happened in Japan and terrorized the country for years. Most of us only think of serial killers and mass murders as the stuff of horror movies or our own sick curiosity. But for other people, these things are quite real. The world contains murderers. Serial murder victims probably thought it couldn't happen to them until it did. It's terrifying to think that you could be doing anything normal like walking down the street or buying groceries or reading an awesome article about serial killers and then, all of a sudden, you're snatched up and thrown into a van, and you won't be found until you're the subject of a podcast 10 years later. According to Discover magazine, less than 1% of homicide victims really face this. The odds are stacked against you, yet people do win the lotto all the time. Known athletes whose horrifying behavior was captured on camera. When killers utilize devious techniques we don't see coming or choose random targets, it's much more horrifying since it shows they're murdering only to kill. The vending machine killer, who operated in Japan in the mid-1980s, was responsible for the murder of as many as 12 people who used vending machines without suspecting anything sinister. In Japan, vending machines have achieved a certain level of cultural significance. Everything from freshly made pizza and hot soup to fresh undergarments for women and, of course, icy soda from the bottle may be purchased at one of their many vending machines. The same icy Coke this murderer drank as he was killing people. Everything about the vending machine killings points to the perpetrator being both significantly different from the typical serial killer and among the cruelest of all time. The first thing to know is that this killer didn't care what kind of person bought a drink with their spare change. And second, the vending machine killer didn't engage in direct interpersonal violence with his victims. According to a UPI report from the time of the occurrence, the man placed poison into beverage bottles and left them in the slot of vending machines in Western Japan, killing anyone who drank from them. In other words, the victim of this poison did not go gently into that good night. It didn't make his victims happy as he swept them away. There was nothing horrific about this toxin. The vending machine murderer used paraquat, a herbicide with a painfully sharp poisonous kick, as his weapon of choice. Paraquat causes slow, gradual tissue damage when taken. The kidneys filter the poison and damage the victim's ability to eliminate it from the system immediately after circulation begins. A cascade of organ failures may follow, but the lungs are usually what gives out first. The lungs are paraquat's principal target, since the herbicide seeks out areas where oxygen levels are high. The victim's lungs fill with fluid and they progressively drown from the inside out as the fibrosis develops. A devastating way to go out. It really shows you that you can't always be too safe, even when you least expect it. The police put in a lot of time and effort, but even the police couldn't crack this case. Poison beverages were obtained from unattended vending machines. Because of this, there were no eyewitnesses who may be able to name any potential threats. It was not filmed by any surveillance cameras. Nor was there any sort of DNA analysis done. More than that, unlike in the majority of murder cases, the motivation for the killings did not shed any light on the situation but instead added layers of complexity. The 12 people who lost their lives were targeted at random and slaughtered in separate incidents at various locations. The killer may have been attracted to the game because of how unpredictable it was, like a sick take on Russian roulette. The only thing any of the victims had in common was that they were all male, with the exception of the last one. But if this was done on purpose, we can only conclude that the killer picked out male-favored beverages to poison or particularly targeted vending machines in male-dominated locations. It might not be a huge leap forward in terms of theory development, but it's the only one we have. In this case, proof was lacking. There was no shred of evidence upon which the police could act. The trail suddenly became cold. The statute of limitations expired over a decade ago. The likelihood of obtaining justice, or even learning why 12 individuals were subjected to such gruesome ends, is zero. Never being able to solve a crime like this is frustrating.
Welcome to the end of the video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. If you have any stories you'd like us to cover, send them to our email in the description. Every episode we are trying our best to improve on quality. Let us know if you like the content in the comments below. As always, stay freaky.